Hello. Now we will see step by step procedure, design procedure of quarter joint. Okay. In last lecture we have seen notation used in a quarter joint design. Okay. Now the first step is tensile failure of rods. In this, small d is calculated. The rod is here in diagram. We have seen the diagram. So in this diagram, this is a rod A and rod B. So tensile failure of a rod in this from this step, we will get diameter of rod. Okay, diameter of rod or diameter of shaft. So tensile failure of rod. Tensile stress in the rod is given by sigma t is equal to p upon area. For a circular rod, the area of circle is pi by 4 d square. Okay. So p by force upon area, this is known as stress. So tensile stress, that is sigma t, is equal to p upon pi by 4 d square. Okay. P, this is a force, and upon area. Area of circle is a pi by 4 d square. Okay. So in this, small d is calculated. Small d is taken in left side and sigma t is on denominator on right side. So small d will be equal to under root 4 p upon pi sigma t. Okay. So from this equation, the value of small d is calculated. Sigma t is a permissible tensile stress. Okay, permissible tensile stress, also known as design stress. Okay, a value of stress given in a numerical. Now, from step 1, we will get diameter of shaft. Now, see the second step, step 2, tensile failure of spigot. The spigot is part of a rod. See, this is a spigot. It is a part of a second rod or rod B. Okay, it is joined to the rod B. Now in step 2 we will see tensile failure of spigot. In figure shows wicked section of spigot end, which is subjected to tensile stress. The area of section at xx section is pi by 4 d square minus d2 into small t. Okay, so in every step, the area of section is the calculation or deriving the area of section at which the total force is acting. So this is very important, because in every step we have to calculate various stresses. Okay, and from these various stresses we will get various unknown value, like a small d. First we will get small d, then a d1, small d1, d2, d3, d4, then small a, b, c, etc. This value we will get, and from this value we have to draw a final diagram of quarter joint. Okay, so this will be our answer, design procedure, and after that the final diagram of a quarter joint. Okay. In first step we got small d, that is diameter of shaft. Now for a spigot, the area at which the tensile force is acting is this. Okay. Now how this area is calculated? Now see the diagram from book. Okay. This is a spigot, pi by 4 d square minus d2 into small t. D2 into small t. Now see, this is a t thickness. This diagram is a left hand side view, and this is a front view. Okay, from left hand side view you will see the thickness of a quarter. This is a quarter and this is the thickness of quarter. small t is the thickness. Now t, small t will be acting at this pivot end, okay, and the small t, d2 is a, this length is a d2, okay, this length is d2. See, this is a pivot and this is a d2, okay, diameter of this pivot is small d2, okay, diameter of this pivot is small d2. Now d2 into t is the, this is d2 into t will be rectangular area subjected to quarter, okay, this is a meeting area of quarter and pivot end, okay, this area will be d2 into t, this will be rectangular area, okay. Imagining of area is very important in every design procedure, okay. Now this is a two dimensional diagram, but imagining of area is very important, okay, from which you will understand how area is taken for each and every cross section, and after calculating the area you will get respective stresses, okay. Now see step 2, we have come at step 2. Area of section at x axis is pi by 4 d square minus d2 into t. Pi by 4 d square will be area, circular area of a rod, minus d2 into t is a rectangular area corresponding to mating part of quarter and rod. Now tensile stress in the pivot. After getting the area, the stress will be P upon area, that is force upon area. Now sigma t, that is tensile stress in the pivot, is equal to P upon pi by 4 d2 square minus d2 into. So P will be equal to pi by 4 d2 square minus d2 into t into sigma t. After calculating small d, t can be calculated by empirical relation. T is equal to 0.31 into small d. This is the value from which you will get small d2, okay, and t is equal to 0.31 into d, small d. This is the empirical formula, okay. In after step 1, you will get value of small t directly, that is equal to small t is equal to 0.31 into small d. Okay, use this small t value in here, and use this small t value here, and you will get the value of small d2, okay, which is the diameter of pivot. Now step 3 is tensile failure of socket. Figure shows weakest section at yy of the socket end, which is subjected to tensile stress. The area of this section is, now tensile failure, for a tensile failure of socket, see the socket is, see this is a socket, this is socket, okay, now here it is quarter is inserted in this rectangular slot of socket end. Now area corresponding to the socket end is equal to pi by 4 d. See, pi by 4 d1 square minus d2 square minus d1 minus d2 into small t. Okay. Pi by 4 d1 square minus d2 square. D1 square minus d2 square is taken because socket is, see, here socket is a hollow cylindrical, socket has a hollow cylindrical section, okay, see here you can see that socket is a hollow cylindrical section because a inner pivot is inserted in this socket, so socket is a hollow cylindrical section. So pi by 4 minus pi by 4 in bracket d1 square minus d2 square is taken, okay, this is a ring area, okay, minus d1 minus d2 into t. Now d1 minus d2 is a thickness, d1 minus d2 is thickness, this is the thickness, d2 is this and d1 is this diameter, okay. See here, d1 is this diameter, diameter of socket end, and d2 is the diameter of pivot end. D1 minus D2 will be the remaining length into thickness, that is T. T is the thickness of quarter. Okay. In step 3, the area of this section is pi by 4 D1 square minus D2 square minus D1 minus DT into small d. And tensile strength at section Y1 is force upon area, that is P upon area, where area is this term. Okay. Now, so force will be P is equal to area into sigma T. Here you will get the value of D1. You have got value of D2 in step 2. T also you have got. Now, from this equation, outside diameter of socket, that is D1, can be determined. So, step by step, each various values can be calculated. Now, shear failure of cutter. First step. Fourth step is shear failure of cutter. The area of each of two planes that resists shear failure is V into T. Shear stress in the cutter is tau is equal to. So, area of each two planes that resist shearing failure is V into T. Now, there is a, in this diagram, there are two planes. So, 2 into V into T is taken, the total area. Okay. And shear stress in this quarter is P upon 2 into V T, where tau is permissible shear stress for the quarter. So, shear stress is equal to P upon 2 into V T. The mean width of quarter B can be determined from this step. Okay. Now see the shear failure of pivot end. Shear failure of pivot end. The pivot end is subjected to double shear as shown in figure. The area of each of the two planes that is a shear failure is A into D2. Shear stress in the pivot end is given by. So, in every step, it is very important to calculate or see the area which resists the force. Okay. Here, in this step, shear failure of pivot end, in this step, the area which resists the force is A into D2. So, shear stress in the pivot end is given by tau is equal to P upon 2 times A into D2. Okay. So, now we know all value except small a. So from this step 5 we will get the value of small a. Okay. Likewise other steps are here. Other steps we will see in next lecture.